Hi, I'm Pasi. I'm CEO of Solar Foods. Solar Foods is bringing to the market a completely new kind of protein you never had before. It differs from all the food on the market today by how it's produced, because its production does not need the practice of agriculture nor aquaculture. From background, I'm an energy engineer. I used to lead as a scientist, single largest renewable energy research in the country so far, 10 million research euro research program. The target of that program was to design an energy system that could be based on 100% renewable energy sources. So our company, Solar Foods, and the colleagues, all also former researchers, we've been lead for a decade in the world that is now discussed in under different kind of climate agreements. This week in Poland, in negotiations, Paris Agreement and IPCC reports. Now, anything that is in contradiction with this one, basically achieving carbon neutral world by 2050, mid of the century, doesn't live in our view. Now, if you look at how carbon neutrality could be achieved on this planet, the problem is twofold. Firstly, you actually need to reinvest the energy system. 80% of the carbon footprint due to human action comes from the energy sector. Now, we know technically, and also I know from my background, how technically the energy system is reinvested and built even based on 100% renewables to be carbon neutral. Technically, it can be done. The rest is political will, so kind of a boarding from a research point of view. Now, the real problem is that about 20% of the carbon footprint due to human action is due to what we eat. And that must be also become zero in a couple of decades. So it's not enough to deal with the energy system. Now, the problem with the current food system is that about 40% of the habitable land is already consumed by meat production. More than half of the land area is occupied by agriculture, and 80% of that due to meat production, although it produces and generates only 20% of the calories what we eat. So according to some estimations, according to UN, we might need to produce 70% more food on this planet by mid of the century. So tell me how it's done from this piece of land. Another view is to look to the sea. The global peak catch of fish occurred 20 years ago. After that, the global catch has been in decline. Fish is the most important protein source for about 1 billion people, and the primary, the important source for 2.5 billion primary protein source for about 1 billion people. And more engine power is consumed to going farther to the sea. So how do we extrapolate more from this? Now, our solution is electricity in terms of energy system, but also now food production. Electricity will be the new primary energy. We need to electrify things, transport, industrial processes, heating, cooling, and so on. Some people like carbon capture storage, so we continue burning things, but you capture the carbon and put it under zero somewhere. Some like nuclear, some like renewables. Whatever you choose, electricity will be the new primary energy, okay? And one example, a good example of the future of electricity becoming raw material is solar PV. The cheapest electricity on the planet today is actually solar PV, 15 euros per megawatt hour in the sun belt of the world. The price of module has been in steep decline and annual installations are increasing. So this is kind of the new energy world, whether it's solar or wind power. This is the new energy world where electricity becomes raw material. You can start to produce things based on electricity. So that's about energy. Another view to food is that the fundamental process that we need to end on this planet is the mining of fossil fuels from the ground. Once the carbon enters above terrestrial, it tends to get oxidized, turned into CO2, and then basically warming the planet. So fundamentally, we need to cut off from there. And actually, it's not that much of a problem if you look at it, because you can take CO2 as a carbon neutral source of carbon. And that is what we do at Solar Foods. So Solar Foods is searching for natural organisms that can be found at your backyard as well. We are searching carefully of these, and we have a variety of available today. And we use so-called bioprocess to cultivate and grow these microorganisms. And what we need is water and CO2, and that we can capture from the air. It's not that much of a problem. We have the technology as well. Then you put in some vitamins and electricity and grow the microbes. So after all this, there's the question, I didn't really get that, how it's produced. So most of us know how beer or wine is done. So you have sugars liquid, then you put in yeast, and that uses the sugars liquid as a source of carbon and energy. Now we disconnect completely from the use of land. We don't use sugars that originate from plant. Instead, we make hydrogen with electricity and take CO2 from the air and feed them into the reactors where the microbes wait, naturally occurring microbes wait, and eat the hydrogen as a source of energy and CO2 as a source of carbon. And then they grow and multiply. You take the liquid out, dry it, and then you end up with a powder. And actually, because you disconnect from land use, we've been asked by European Space Agency to develop a concept, a version of our technology for the future Mars mission. So in flight or at the destination, you could actually produce food with this technology. It is about 50% protein. And this is how it looks. It's like a powder, like wheat flour. Now, the impact potential is huge. There are about 10,000 edible species we use commercially on this planet, about 200 species. But one of the problems for obesity and maybe diabetes as well is that 17 species provide 75% of the calories on this planet. And 60% of the plant-based calories are provided by only 3 plant species. Now, if we look at the small life, microbial life, there's a huge diversity of life, naturally occurring life, that we haven't harvested. So this new kind of life, new diet, we can open up and harvest for the human guide. And because it's a closed process, we use less water than the current alternatives where you are connected to land use, and our land use efficiency is actually very high compared to the current food system, whether it's meat or plant-based stuff. So where do you use this powder then? We end up with a powder. Actually, it's surprisingly diverse how you can use it. So it can be part of your breakfast in cereals, or it can be part of pasta, bread, pizza, different kinds of shakes and drinks and in treats. And what we also can do, we can supply the protein content and calories to plant-based meat alternatives, and also the culture media for cultured meat growing, because still you need the energy and amino acids from somewhere. So surprisingly, this powder seemed to have diverse uses. Now, there's plenty of market. We think that today the meat alternative market is about $5 billion annually, and their estimation that it increased at least 100-fold by mid of the century. Thank you.